Welcome back. It has been quite the week for Augustana Athletics. Despite any weather conditions, the Vikings are into a very strong spring season, and the NSIC and the nation are taking notice. We'll start on the diamond. The honors keep coming for Augustana softball senior infielder Kaylee Shore. Not only did she take home the NSIC Player of the Week award, but it was announced yesterday that she earned the National Fast Pitch Coaches Association Player of the Week. Shore batted 526 last week with a homer and 8 RBI. This week isn't getting off to a good start, though, but it's not her fault by any means. Augie's doubleheader with Upper Iowa that was scheduled for today was canceled due to snowy conditions in Fayette, Iowa. However, the Vikings will still make the trip to Minot, North Dakota for a pair of doubleheaders in Minot's air-supported dome against UMary and Minot State. Augustana enters the week ranked 16th in the nation. They sit atop the NSIC standings, and the Vikings are riding a 6-game winning streak. More from the diamond. This time we're talking Augustana baseball. The Vikings recently moved up one spot to number 3 in the latest Division II NCBWA Top 25 poll. Augie received one first place vote for the week, and the number 3 nod marks the program's highest ranking in school history. The Vikings went 6-0 last week and tied their season best winning streak with 12. Augie started the week with a shutout and 8 Ks from senior right-hander Tyler Mitzel in a 4-0 win over Upper Iowa. They got more stellar pitching from Jacob Blank and David Flattery, who each went 7 innings with 10 and 11 strikeouts, respectively. In wins over Bemidji State, Sam Beyer, Riley Johnson, and Ryan Nickel led the team in hitting. Here's Vikings head coach Tim Huber on the successful spring thus far.
Well, winning helps, I guess, right? I mean, they're playing loose, and it's been a challenging spring. There's no doubt about it. There's been a lot of changes in the schedule and communication with professors and classes. We talk a lot about that. Just stay in communication with everyone and get your homework done when you're on the bus. And yeah, it has its challenges, but that's part of being a spring sport. And so far, we're thriving on it.
Augie is in the middle of a doubleheader right now against St. Cloud State, and then they hit the road to play UMary this weekend. The Vikings currently hold the best winning percentage in Division II at 960. On to the tennis court, the Augustana tennis team has been a perennial favorite over the years, winning 8 straight conference championships. So far this season, they sit atop the NSIC with a 16-3 overall record and a perfect 9-0 mark in league play. As released yesterday afternoon, Augie came in at the number 5 spot in the first NCAA Central Region rankings of the season, sitting behind Oklahoma Baptist at number 4, Southwest Baptist at number 3, Central Oklahoma in second, and Northeastern State at the top spot. The Central Region is comprised of 29 teams from the NSIC, MIAA, and the GAC. The Vikings finish up their regular season with matches against St. Cloud State and UMD this weekend up in Duluth, Minnesota. All right, last from Augustana, but not least. For the second week in a row, an Augie golfer earned the NSIC Golfer of the Week. And last week, it was Kaylee Troutman. This week, Sierra Langley took home the honor. Langley was one of 2 unranked golfers to finish in the top 10 at the West Texas A&M Invitational. This marks her 5th career NSIC Golfer of the Week honor and her first this season. Up next for Vikings Golf is the Augustana Spring Fling right here in Sioux Falls on April 14th and 15th. Make sure to watch tomorrow's Midco Sports Tonight as we'll chat with the Augie golf team about their season so far. Staying in the NSIC, but talking women's hoops now. NDSU's Anna Goodhope decided to transfer to the University of Sioux Falls. Goodhope was an all-state performer in high school for Sioux Falls, Washington, and then played 1 year at NDSU in the 2016-17 season, where she averaged 9.6 minutes per game as a freshman. She sat out last season for the Bison and will be eligible to play for the Cougars in this upcoming season. And finally, we haven't talked a lot about soccer on the show, but here's some great news. Soccer fans will remember Sioux Falls native and former Bemidji State All-American defender Miranda Famestad. She recently signed a contract to play professionally for Valens IF in Stora Higa, Sweden. Valens IF is a member of the Swedish Women's Football Division 4 and competes in the Bohuslän Dalsland League, which is the sixth tier of the Swedish Football Association. Valens has played for the Swedish Cup on three occasions and won its league as recently as 2008. Famestead was a first-team All-NSIC selection in 2017 and the NSIC Defensive Player of the Year that same year. Switching gears to North Dakota high school football, Jamestown High School is trying to stay put in Class 2A. If you remember a few weeks ago, our Jody Norstead discussed the move from 14 teams to 16 teams in Class 3A in 2019 for North Dakota. Well, Jamestown's enrollment put them at 15 on the list, and Shanley opted up to replace Devil's Lake as the 16th team. But earlier this week, news broke that Jamestown High sent a formal letter to the NDHSAA football committee stating that the school would prefer to remain in Class 2A, citing competitive balance as one of the main reasons. Jamestown dropped down to 2A last season and won six games, which is double the amount they had won in the previous two seasons combined at the 3A level. The football committee will have a chance to review the football plan before finalizing it in September, and we'll keep you updated on that situation. We're going to step away for a moment, but when we come back, we'll chat about what's to come tomorrow on Midco Sports Tonight, and we'll go through the weekend schedule for Midco Sports Network. Stay right here.